Ngiyabingelela bazalwane egameni lenkosi ethu Jesu Christ. I'm so excited to be spending so much time with you every day. I'm in your face and I'm having a great time. Hopefully you're having a great time with me as well. I know there's a bit of frustration. You're sitting at home, you want to do more stuff, you want to go to work, you know, it's success in your mind. But guess what? God is on your side. It's a great time to have time with family. Number two, it's a great time to read the word. Number three, it's also a great time for you to focus on prayer. Pray a minimum of 3 times a day. Let's go to the scripture. I'm glad we've been speaking about overcoming fear, overcoming fear of failure, having faith. But I want you to give you practical examples of overcoming negative thoughts. How do you overcome negative thoughts? It happens to everyone. That is impossible. That no. If you are one of those people, how do you deal with yourself? If you are not one of those people, you know, obviously it's easier to avoid such people. But if you can't avoid them, mhlambe spouse sakho, mhlambe umuntu osebenza naye, mhlambe ohlala naye ekhaya, a friend, etc., etc. But how do you help them to be able to get to a point where they deal with those negative thoughts? Because negative thoughts can be limiting because they lead to fear. Now, let's go to the Word of God. So, the Word of God, we're going to look at two scriptures. The first scripture is Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. Paul, we tell my believers what to think about. Think about those things that are true, those things that are noble, those things that are right, those things that are pure, those things that are lovely, those things that are admirable, those things that are excellent, and those things that are praiseworthy. What does it conclude with? Think about these things. Another version says, New American Standard says, dwell on these things. The New American Standard 1977, let your mind think on these things. Jubilee Bible 2000, exercise your thoughts on those things. And then the Amplified say, think of these things continually. And then another one, the Aramaic Bible, meditate on those things. That's deep now. It's getting deeper. It says meditate on those things. So in other words, what are those things? Things that are pure, lovely, right, admirable, excellent, praiseworthy, and noble and true. And all these things is unazidofuneka ingqondo yakho sonke isikhathi. So bese siyadlula siya ku scripture sethu sokugcina, 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 3 and 6. For though we live in the world, we do not wage the war as the world does. The weapons we fight are not the weapons of the world. On the contrary, there are divine power to demolish strongholds. To demolish, so if a little later. But strongholds are here in the mind. Strong impi esbegene nayo isengqondweni. Impi esbegene nayo ayikho enyameni kodwa isengqondweni. Uma ungaqala utshela ingqondo yakho ukuthi ayidwele kwini, umlomo wakho uzoqala ukhulume lokho right. Umlomo wakho wakhuluma ukuright konke okunye, umpilo yakho nomzimba wakho nako konke okubizwa ngegama lakho will begin to follow. What will it follow? It will follow what you speak, having been directed by what you think. So dwell on the great things, noble, true, praiseworthy, excellent, etc., etc. But more importantly, impi esibhekene nayo isengqondweni. If you conquer the mind, if you conquer the strongholds in God, you have conquered the enemy. Tomorrow, we're going to speak about the renewal of the mind. I want you to understand how to overcome ingqondo. Because with ingqondo, more of overcoming, you have won the biggest battle of fear and failure and rejection in your life. God bless you. See you tomorrow.